Welcome back to America Trends. You are with the U2 America TV Network and Biz Talk Radio. I'm Amy Fuller. We are along with the American Truth Project's Barry Nussbaum here in just a moment. And what we are, well, there you can find the website, all kinds of news stories of the day and insight that you won't find anywhere else. Iran now, though. The U.S. does not believe the threat from Iran is over after those two oil tankers came under suspected attack Thursday. Senior officials say the U.S. has photographed an unexploded mine on the side of one of the tankers near the Strait of Hormuz, and they do believe Iran is responsible. So there's a lot going on, a lot of tension with Iran and so many other countries, and we're chatting with Barry about it right now. This is a very crucial area of the sea, Barry, and what are they just trying to jump bad with all of us, or what?
The Straits of Hormuz, somewhere between 20% and 30% of the world's oil supply goes through that choke point on an annual basis, Amy. So when the Grand Ayatollah in Iran, who is the basically dictator, religious dictator of the country, not elected, he's there for life or until someone kills him, declared last month that his intention was to choke off the oil supply going through the strait, people, especially the Western world, should have taken him seriously. Since then, there have been a number of attacks that are absolutely, unequivocally traceable to the footprints and fingerprints of Iran. They started out with the threat actually in April. Shortly thereafter, pipelines were blown up in Saudi Arabia. Drone strikes took place, very close overflights of American ships by drones took place. Then four tankers were blown up in April. The United States started the investigation, and all fingers were pointing at Iran. And now, as you said, this week, two more oil tankers were blown up by marine landmines attached to the sides of these monster tankers. The U.S. Navy had to intercede, Amy, and actually rescue crew members. So on top of that, there was a bombing that injured a number of U.S. forces in Afghanistan. There was a missile strike against the American embassy in Iraq. And the airport, the international airport in Saudi Arabia, was hit by one or two missiles, injuring some 29 people. So Iran is reaching out and striking everywhere, and it's shocking to me that these are acts of war that will impact the world economy to the point where oil prices are now skyrocketing, and yet nothing is being done against Iran. And the cause of this apparently is the Trump sanctions have ratcheted up another level because Iran is going in the opposite direction, which is towards uranium enhancement. And even the IAEA says they could be on the brink of a nuclear bomb in under a month. And there's nothing anybody is doing about it other than the sanctions, which I applaud the president for, but so far, no positive effect that we can see.
These sanctions enacted by the U.S., they were supposed to kick in this week. Is that right, Barry?
Yeah, they've just taken effect this week. I think it's the third level of ratchet up. Look, Amy, the Iranian economy is in free fall. They're in big trouble. So what do dictators do, like Iran, when things get rough? It's no different than Venezuela or Cuba or North Korea. The people that need the food, the water, the jobs, and so on are the ones that suffer, and the military brutal dictatorship spends their money on weapons and terror.
Sure.
Remember, we funded Iran to the tune of billions and billions and billions of dollars sent to them by Barack Obama because he promised Iran would be just like us and pursue peace. And all they've done since they've gotten the money is export terror everywhere. In steps Donald Trump and says, the terror's got to stop. The missile development has got to stop. No more ICBMs and certainly no more nuclear uranium enhancement that could be used for bombs. And instead, what does Iran do? Starts attacking oil tankers. That's why oil prices have been climbing up steadily on a daily basis. We are either headed for a war of limited engagement or something larger. And now Iran is threatening Israel as well to distract from the fact that they are in deep, deep economic trouble.
And these attacks caused serious damage to these ships, at least one fire there, and 44 sailors had to be rescued at sea. So it's no joke. It could have been much, much worse. So when you say nothing is being done, Barry, what should be done?
Well, you know, it's a difficult question to answer. You would first say as a diplomat, Amy, well, the United Nations ought to do something. Well, the United Nations is filled with supporters of pan-Arab Muslim hierarchies that unite against any kind of resolution that would control and put stronger sanctions on them. So what the president, our president, thank goodness, has done is said, you know, I'm not going to wait for the UN. I'm not going to wait for the EU. I'm going to institute very harsh sanctions. And if the rest of the world gets behind the United States, Iran will become more and more and more isolated. The second issue, in a direct answer to your question, Amy, is a military response. If Mike Pompeo's speech that he gave at the State Department turns out to be true and is demonstrable on a world stage, Mike Pompeo, Secretary of State, said they have absolute proof. The IRGC, the Iran Revolutionary Guard Corps, is behind these attacks. Then what should happen is the fleet is there. The Abraham Lincoln carrier group is literally on site, and there's going to be military actions on top of the economic sanctions.
We just went over a few things, some huge news from this week, as well as this, that they are pointing the finger at Iran, the U.S. is, for an attack on two oil tankers near the Strait of Hormuz, and, you know, the second in 1 month's time. And Barry, so May 12th, four tankers attacked with mines. May 14th, two pipelines blown up in Saudi Arabia. And then a missile at a U.S. embassy in Iraq. And then various drone overflights. Do you want to just wrap that up a little bit and we'll move on to the other topic? Because this is something we're going to be hearing about this in coming days. And, you know, it could get far, far worse.
The thing that's the most troubling, Amy, about this is certain noise out of the EU saying, well, Iran wouldn't do this if the United States just supported the Iran nuclear deal.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
That is appeasement on nuclear steroids, as if to say, you know, the reason why he beat her up is she didn't smile nicely. It's not an excuse to beat somebody up. Iran is breaking international law. It's a terroristic state. These acts of terrorism border on declarations of war against international shipping, against the United States and our allies, and the world should unite against Iran. And there ought to be a really, really strong message sent militarily, because I got news for you. People, especially where you are in California, are very upset about gas prices. If the price of oil goes up 20 or 30%, the price at the pump would go to the moon very quickly. And I think that's what Iran wants to do. They want to be so obnoxious, so aggressive, that the appeasers around the world that say peace at any cost, like 1938, you know, when the UK went to Germany to appease Hitler, what they got in exchange was World War II. And if we don't move aggressively to shut this down, we're going to have some sort of conflict that gets bigger by the day if we don't choke it off now. That's my take on it.
That's what you think will happen next?
I think so.